Okay, dear students, let's continue with metal reactivity. The next part, okay, don't forget the Penang Sports Club, potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, lead, copper. Okay, and then the last video that I did there was related to how iron and tin can be extracted by using carbon. But today, our focus, our hero for today is Mr. Hydrogen. Where is hydrogen? Hydrogen is after zinc, before iron. After zinc, before iron, got hydrogen. After zinc, before iron, got hydrogen. And one thing you must be clear is, if anything that is hydrogen is before, that means this is most reactive. This one is very reactive. This one less reactive. Why now only we put in hydrogen, carbon and all that? Because hydrogen, carbon, all these are non-metals. You want to see how non-metals react with the metal. So what happens here is, look at the simple experiment here, guys. Dry hydrogen gas is put inside. Here, this metal oxide is already heated up. It's already being heated up together. You heat up this metal oxide there. So as metal oxides get heated up, as this hydrogen comes in, let's say like example, the metal oxide here is iron oxide. Can be any metal oxide, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, lead, copper, but let's say it's iron oxide. So what is happening here? We can see clearly the hydrogen comes before iron. Hydrogen comes before iron. That means who is more reactive? Hydrogen is more reactive. When hydrogen is more reactive, what it will do is hydrogen will go and churi the oxide. When it churi the oxide, maka becomes water, then becomes water there. So what is left is the iron. The metal that is left there will be the iron. Another good example will be these guys. Lead oxide. That means this metal now changed to lead oxide. It's not iron oxide, now lead oxide. Plus you put hydrogen gas comes inside. What will happen is lead is here. So hydrogen is more reactive compared to lead. What will happen here is you will get lead plus hydrogen oxygen. So the hydrogen will churi the oxide, become water will be present there. Okay, can I clear this up? But let's just say, guys. Now you take aluminium oxide. Aluminium is before hydrogen. Aluminium, carbon, non-metal, then zinc, then only hydrogen comes in. Hydrogen is here, aluminium is here. Hydrogen is here, aluminium is here. So now plus with hydrogen, will anything happen? Nothing will happen. Why nothing will happen? Because aluminium is more reactive compared to hydrogen. So aluminium will keep the oxygen together. Hydrogen got no power, because who is more powerful? Aluminium is more powerful. When aluminium is more powerful, you cannot take out the oxygen. You cannot churi the oxygen. So remains same for this. Here, who more powerful? Hydrogen more powerful. So hydrogen more powerful, slap the iron filler, say shut up to the iron filler, churi the oxygen, so becomes water. What is left is iron. Here also same, hydrogen more powerful, hydrogen churi the oxygen, becomes water. What is left behind is the lead. Okay, can I guys clear on this? This one is the same thing we did for the carbon. If anything that is more reactive, carbon is more reactive, we can go and churi the oxygen. If it's less reactive, we cannot go and churi the oxygen. So be clear on this. This time your worksheet is more latihan. So the next part, I'll just give you the answers for it. Any parts that are more difficult needs me to explain a little bit more, I'll explain before we go to the next chapter. Okay, hopefully this helps you guys. Be clear on this. A lot of latihan on this part. This is a basic for chemistry. Basic for chemistry. So make sure you clear on this part. Yeah. That's all today, guys. Take care. Good week.
Daddy, I just slapped something on the